Hey, what's up you guys? It's Emily. Welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome to my channel. So today I will be talking about how I've gotten my subscribers and how I've progressed throughout YouTube in the past year. And I know, first of all, that I am not the biggest YouTuber, you don't have to tell me, but I have a lot of people asking me questions, like at least weekly, on different platforms on how I do stuff or the equipment I use or how I got subscribers or everything like that. So I just wanted to sit down and answer these questions for you guys because I want to help you guys out. And yeah, so let's jump right in. Okay, so the first question I get a lot is, what kind of camera do I use? So I use a, I have to read this because it's a long name. I use a Canon EOS 5D Mark III, or like Mark III, because they do Roman numerals. So anyways, so that is the camera that I use. So I'm gonna talk about cameras for a second, because if you're starting out a YouTube channel, the first couple months or even month you start, I would not recommend getting a really nice camera. And the reason I say that is because YouTube might not stick. And if you don't like YouTube and you only do it for a week and you just bought a $600 camera, it doesn't make sense to go out and spend all your money on that if it's a hobby that you're just testing out and you're not sure if you're gonna do it long term. Now, if you make it past a month or two and you're deciding, oh, like, this is something that I really enjoy, this is something that's gonna stick with me, then I 100% would go out and buy a good camera. So my camera, I would have never been able to afford by myself. This is like a upward couple $1,000 camera. And the only reason I have it is because my dad's really good friend, who's a professional photographer, didn't want it and said it was collecting dust in his closet and just gave it to me to use. And I'm really thankful for that. So I doubt he's watching it, but if you are, thank you. And yeah, so that's how I got this camera. I would have never been able to afford anything like this. So some like cameras that I would recommend starting out with, I know that if I wasn't gonna get this camera, I wanted the Rebel T6i. So that's just one that a lot of YouTubers recommend and start out with. So if you're interested, that's just my recommendation. Once again, do your own research. Maybe that's not the camera for you. And yeah. Okay, so the next question that I get often is, what do I use to edit? And I actually just use iMovie. I want Final Cut Pro, and I went to buy Final Cut Pro thinking it was like $50, but it's upward like $300. So I'm waiting on that for right now. There's a lot of cool stuff though that you can do on iMovie. So the way I do my social media banners, if you want to go on YouTube itself and then type in like social media banners for iMovie or theme packs for iMovie and just see what there is out there, you can really deck out your iMovie depending on what you want. So yeah, that's just something I would do. You can make iMovie as creative as you want. You just need to put some effort into it because iMovie takes a little more effort. Okay, so this is my biggest question I think I get when people direct message me and ask me how I get my subscribers. So once again, I know I don't have the most subscribers on YouTube. I'd still consider myself a small YouTuber, but people want to know how I've gotten 5,000 subscribers in a year. So the honest truth on how I've gotten 5,000 subscribers in a year is I just really network with other small YouTubers. So by this I mean, if I see somebody's video that I like who's of about the same subscribers as me and I really like their videos and I genuinely can see myself watching them down the road, so I'm not gonna subscribe to somebody that I'm not interested in because then I'm never gonna watch their videos and that's not fair to them. So I'll find somebody that I genuinely enjoy, probably makeup, and I'll just let them know that I subscribe to them and I enjoy their content, and if they want to subscribe back, they can. If they don't want to, okay. And then I just continue to support them. And that's another thing, I think that you shouldn't just say that you subscribe to them one time and then unsubscribe after they subscribe to you, because that's not fair. I mean, and you're kind of being deceitful. So be genuine. If it's content that you like, subscribe to them, let them know. If they want to subscribe back, they can. If not, okay. The other way I got a lot of subscribers was from one of my TJ Maxx videos, high-end makeup that I found at TJ Maxx. That did really well. I think it got 26,000 views. I got a couple hundred subscribers from that. And yeah, so I mean, it really just genuinely depends. I like to keep up with trends sometimes in YouTube, not always, because I like to make my YouTube channel my own, so a lot of the trends I don't really care for. But yeah, so I like to keep kind of current with the trends for certain things that I like. And then as a result, I got a lot of views on some of my videos, and that led to me getting a couple hundred subscribers, so yes. Okay, another question that I've only got asked a couple times because I feel like nobody wants to overstep a boundary or anything. Nobody wants to actually ask me how much money I make. I think people in my personal life ask me more than people on the internet because I think people on the internet don't want to come off as rude. But yeah, so how much money have I made? So a little background about me. I've been on YouTube for about a year, but I just started gaining subscribers maybe 10, 11 months ago. So up to date, I don't think I'm allowed to tell you how much exactly I've made, but I could tell you a roundabout number. So I can tell you it's more than $275, but it's less than $375. So not a whole lot. That's like half a month's rent for apartments around here. So I just started getting paid a month ago, and I hadn't got paid before then. And that's okay because I do YouTube as a hobby. I didn't come on this network thinking that I was even gonna have this many subscribers ever. So it's not something that bothers me. So for me, this is okay. I know for a lot of people, they might be like, you've been on here for a year and you've only made that much money. I'm happy I made money at all. I didn't expect it at all. So that kind of leads me to my next thing that I would just recommend for people who are just starting out with their YouTube channel. Kind of decide if before starting your YouTube channel in general, do you want it to be more of a business for you or do you want it to be more recreational? So just, you don't have to stick to it. So like, let's say you want to start out for fun and then you want it to become a business. That's fine. But the reason I say that is because you're gonna wanna do a lot more branding friendly things. So I don't swear on any of my videos. And that's not really because I'm doing it to brand. It's kind of doing it because I know some of my like younger family watches me. But a lot of businesses won't wanna collaborate with you if they look at your channel and you're just constantly swearing. Which, by the way, I will say that some of YouTube creators who swear all the time are so fun and like so cool to watch. So there's not a right or wrong way, and there's not a way I prefer, because I think if you want to have your channel be your own and you want to swear, that's fine. Go ahead. Like, it doesn't affect me. It might be like unadvertiser friendly. It might not be advertiser friendly, but you're at least you're doing what you want. So that would be more for a fun way. But if you want to be a business, I would suggest, you know, carrying yourself properly, being like a little more mannered in your videos, just stuff like that. It's something to think about, because when brands look at your channel, like I said, if you're swearing up a storm, maybe a brand won't want to work with you anymore. It's just something to think about, but once again, it's up to you what you want to make your channel. Okay, another question I used to get more frequently than I get now is, how do I deal with hate comments? And honestly, it's like, it's fine to me. I have thick skin. I knew that coming onto the internet, that just takes one troll to find your channel for them to leave a hate comment. And I'm not gonna feel down about something that somebody said, because first of all, think about the person. Think about the mindset you have to go onto somebody's video that you have no clue who they are and leave a hate comment on their appearance or the way their channel is or anything like that. So thankfully, I think I've had, I could count on one hand or maybe two hands how many hate comments I've gotten, and they don't really affect me. I just delete them. I don't reply to them because it's not even worth your time. I will delete them, block them, and then that's it. And I just keep it pushing, because I'm not gonna let one person whose main goal on the internet is to bring other people down stop me from making content. And I don't think they should stop you guys either. It's kind of a slap in the face to them if you just delete the comment, block them, and keep moving and keep creating good content, because they failed at what they were trying to do, which is make you miserable or make you stop posting. So okay, and then the last question I think is super nice that some people ask me, and it's how do I get confident in front of the camera, which even though like I'm doing it right now, like I'm talking to you guys and you guys might think this is my whole personality, in real life I'm way funnier, well I would like to think anyways, but I think I'm way sillier, I'm way more goofy, and I think when I'm on here I kind of collect myself in a different way. I'm more structured and I don't feel like I let my full personality onto the camera yet. You could probably see it more when I'm in vlogs with my friends, my full personality, but I mean, just as far as like this goes, it took me a while. I remember the first time I ever sat down in front of the camera, I literally could not even talk. I was so nervous, I was shaking. I remember I was on FaceTime with my friend Cecily and she was like, you could do it, you could do it. And I was just so nervous for no reason. I mean, nobody's technically right there in front of me, but I know that when I put it on the internet, hundreds of thousands of millions of people could potentially see it. But now it's just kind of, I feel comfortable. It's something that I've been doing for a while. Practice makes perfect. If you want to practice, turn on your camera and just talk to it for a little bit, kind of get more comfortable in front of it, and then sit down and really film the video, because trust me, I've been there. I know how it feels to be so like nervous in front of the camera, and it just takes time, it takes practice, and you eventually will get there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I could help somebody out. If you guys liked it, don't forget to subscribe and like and leave a comment. Tell me anything. How are you guys doing starting out your channels? Are you thinking about starting out a channel? And just talk. I love to talk to you guys in the comments. So I love you guys so much and I can't wait to see you next time. Bye guys.